Sadly, this man earlier this year was denied health care from the National Health Service. Can you believe that? Do you know why?
Nice mask. You're beautiful, doggy. Hey, you're beautiful. You like, I said, don't you look at this? You want to give cuddles? Yeah, and you want to do something? Get off. Honestly, I said, get off. Honestly, stop it. Stop it. I'm going to have your knackers chopped off. Stop it. Stop it. What? What is it? What is it? Can't have you in wicked way. You can't have your wicked way. I love you trying to get down and dirty or cuddle. What's he doing? What's he doing to you?
So what's the first one reading? Because that's exactly what's happening, isn't it? Sports people, elite sports people, when it comes to their profession, why is it that they're dropping? Is it because of their diet? What's gone wrong? What's gone wrong? Ask yourself the question. Ask the people who are being ignorant to the fact why world-class athletes are dropping. There's only one answer, absolutely. And these are these injections. And what are they?
Experiments.
Absolutely, yes, thank you. And this is the situation which we're living in. It's deception. It's deception, guys. This is what we are living in today. The truth being seen as the false and the false being seen as the truth. And it's as simple as that. We are living through a deception. I posted Lisa Shaw's death on my social media a few weeks ago. Does anyone know who Lisa Shaw was? The BBC correspondent in the Northeast who passed away. Her post-mortem report said, categorically, that she died because of the jab. The BBC reported their former colleague's death on the BBC. So when I posted it on my social media, guess what happened? It got taken down. Fake news. What a load of bullshit. Yeah? Because that's exactly what is going on. They are obliged to take the jab. Well, they're not. So what difference does it make for them as public-facing employees, as a corporation of Lancashire Constabulary, to NHS staff, care staff? Exactly. Thank you very much. So what? Isn't that discrimination? That's discrimination. What difference does it make for someone in the care sector to their frontline NHS facing staff to somebody like the police? Nothing. Exactly the same. So one rule for one rule for another. It's not fair. And this is the one which was in the news this week. COVID certificate of vaccine ID. So do you know how your MP voted for that this week? And that's another one. MPs are exempt from using vaccine passports. So I'm going to tell you a story. So I live in Blackburn. And who's the MP here? Kate Holland MP. So on the day after the vote in Parliament, I phoned her on her personal mobile. And I wanted to ask her, how did she vote? What did she say? She said she voted in favour. And it's not just the Blackburn MP. But you know what I said to Kate? And I lost my mind, I lost my head. I did get a bit angry with her. But you know what she said to me? Who the hell are you to tell me what to do? Yes, those were her words. Those were exactly her words. Who are you to tell me what to do? So you know what I said to her? Do you know what I said to her? I said to her, oh, that's very well, isn't it? On a Thursday, during general election, the people, you guys, go to a ballot box and put an X in the box. And you're telling me that who are you to tell me what to do? I sent an email to my MP to tell her to vote no. Why? Because this sets a precedent of a mandate, because what they will fucking do is they will remove the lateral flow test element, and then it will just be double jab and your status is of your jab, and that's all it's going to be. This is setting a precedent, as it was happening in Australia and Nazi Germany. That's exactly what's happened. So on the basis of what the vote took place, sadly, there is a legal challenge, a judicial review, if anyone didn't know about this, and it's being presented by a client of a legal firm called Brentnell Legal Limited. So do look them up. It's called Brentnell Legal Limited. So they are actually holding a judicial review on this. And the final one. So is there anybody in the crowd who's been vaccinated? Please don't discriminate, be honest, put your hand up. Never mind, it doesn't matter. Okay, there's one lady there, and there's another gentleman there. That's fine. You know, actually, let's do one thing. To the person to your left, give each other a hug, go on. Come on. There you go. So whose agenda is this? This is people control. This is societal control. This is division. This is division. They've divided us enough through race, religion, but we the people are together today. Man and woman, black and white, doesn't matter what background, race, religion you come from, we're all together. I want to end there. I'm just a normal working class guy, and I want to thank the organisers for bringing this rally to Blackburn, because look, all these protests and rallies take place up and down the country, in the cities majority. In the majority, should I say. Nothing in the working class towns. People need a voice, and I'm so glad that the organisers here today have brought people like you and I together. Junaid, you've probably seen his videos, he's from West Yorkshire. This guy was one of the first people last year, when the vaccine programs rolled out last year, to actually go outside his community centre and say on his son's video camera, which was then published on Channel 4, to say these vaccines will cause harm. He was one of the first people in the UK to do that. And Junaid has been vilified from our community, our Muslim community, where he lives. He's been vilified. People have called him anti-vaxxers. His videos have gone viral. Sadly, this man earlier this year was denied healthcare from the National Health Service. Can you believe that? Do you know why?
Because he won't get vaccinated.
No, because he didn't take a PCR test.
Are you kidding me?
No. He had a heart attack. This man had a heart attack, and when he was taken into A&E, they insisted that he takes a PCR test. Is that acceptable?
No.
Is it acceptable?
No.
Why not? I'll tell you why. Because the National Health Service was founded on the principle of what? free healthcare at the point of contact. How many years ago? 70 plus years ago. And this guy, look, he's still troubled, he's still being affected.
I'm all right.
But he's all right. But God be with him. And the people be with him. Because this guy spoke the truth, continue speaking the truth, and you all are together, standing side by side, together, speaking the truth. And that's what we're here for today.
Awesome.
This is why we're here, yeah?
Yes!
Right, okay? No, it's alright, we'll go. I think you can hear, yeah?
Yeah!
I love to shout. Right, when I came here, when I walked up here, and the music was playing, and I saw the people stood here, and I saw their smiles, and you know what? It was uplifting. And this is where we need to be, guys. Not down in the doldrums and doom and gloom. We need to be elevated.
Yeah.
So have that confidence, guys, that things will get better.
Yeah.
Of course they will. But what we have to do now, yeah, what our job is, and I've mentioned it, talking to people. These are still our brothers and sisters who are misled, who have been fed lies for years, decades, centuries. We have been fed lies upon lies. So what do you expect these people to do? They have been no better. We have to love them. We have to love them. They are our brothers and sisters.
We need to kill fear with our lives.
Yeah. Fear. Fear is their control mechanism. We all know it. We have no fear. I have no fear. No fear. No fear. Because I've got you guys. And this is happening all over the country. Thousands, millions are getting together. This is happening everywhere, trust me. And for the first time in Blackburn, for the first protest, this is really, really good. Because I went to a protest and there was three people. Me and two others. And now at that same event, we have 5,000. So look at you guys. This is absolutely amazing. Have no fear, guys. Fear will hold us back. Fear won't let us succeed. Fear won't let us win. We are going to win this. I promise you, we are going to win this.
Yes!
Yes! Going to win this. Nobody can stop us. Nobody can stop us because we have the grace of God on our side. We are honest. We are truthful. We are caring. We want the best for these guys, don't we? And what about them guys? What do they want? They have no empathy, no sympathy, no remorse, nothing. These people have sold out. They're the devils. Forget about them. We're not going to fight them. We're going to build our own communities. Start building your communities. Start building community schools. Start doing stuff together. Forget them. We don't need their system. We don't need them whatsoever. We need each other. That's all. Remember that. We need each other and keep loving your heart. Please keep loving your heart because with love, we will get through this. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for having us here.
So let's get ready to ramble and tell people the truth. The whole truth and nothing but the truth, so help me God. What you've got there is an English law. That's the Magna Carta. It dates back to 1215. What does it stand for? It stands for freedom. Freedom is what we fought for, our ancestors fought for, and they fought for us. And we're fighting for them kids.
Yeah. Oh, Omicron, we're not morons. We're not walking down. We're not being Christmas round at us. Bodies is a clown.
Hey.
You can stick the bats in passports up your ass.
Take your
mask and cross your arms. See you later.
so much.
This is going to be fun, the moving to vaccine centre. Go on.
Together we are mighty, we are the 99%.